Wait for some of you to hop on here. Hope everybody had a great weekend. I was busy. Finally got to relax a little bit last night. And just chilled. Looking forward to this week. My goodness. Summer is not even heating up yet, and it's been crazy. Crazy, crazy good stuff. Some of you guys, come on. Hope everybody had a good weekend and good Mom's Day, Mother's Day. Hope everybody enjoyed their time with their families. And back to work today. Some reason Mother's Day and Father's Day they're not on the same level for some reason. I don't know about that, but that's what I've heard. I don't want to start any fights here. So basically, I was just thinking about this morning, my quiet time, just going over some stuff and just relaxing and getting ready for the day and preparing for the day. Got a whole yellow notepad filled out for my morning meeting and team meeting. And basically, just looking at the numbers. And thank you, Todd at Hancock, man. He whips out these numbers in no time for me, so I really appreciate him doing that. I wanted to see where we compared to last year. I mean, I look at it every month, but I wanted to see what we're looking at. And growth, we are looking pretty darn good as far as our growth. And just wanted to share with you guys some ideas of why I think that's happened. It's not because, oh, we're awesome and everything else and you know, then that's it. That's just dumb. You got to dig deeper than that. So I wrote down a few things why I think we're going in a direction that we've gone to. And, you know, our goal has been hit, you know, over 60 million this year. You know, last year we did 48 million, and that's on an average loan size of 181, you know. So put things in perspective. I know you boys in California and gals in California out west there, you know, I'm looking for those California mortgage amounts. I don't see them, but us here in Tennessee on the East Coast too, average loan amount is about 181 right now. So for us, you know, when you take all the numbers, divide it, and that's been a number it seemed like for the last 4 or 5 years. So it is what it is. So what we have done, and you know, I think here, number one is having the right people. We have some awesome people. I mean, we got internally, externally, Hancock, you know, closing and underwriting and all that stuff. I mean, everybody works together as a team, and just having some just really awesome people to work with on our team and with Hancock combined, I think is just phenomenal. So that's the first thing. You know, nothing starts, everything ends with that. You have to have great people to work with, okay? Number two, I actually looked at the relationships that we had as far as our referral partners. I know for me, I really had to reanalyze, and I heard it from he's actually a president of a different company, talk about this years ago, and you know, it sounds so simple, but nobody does it, okay, is to reanalyze your relationships and who's sending your business, who you're sending business to, which I think is key. It's not our side of business, it's always one-sided, except for us, you know, here at Hancock, we produce a lot of leads for our agents. But you gotta really analyze who you're in bed with, who you're working with. And really, at the end of the year, that's a good thing to do because, you know, there's a lot of people who create a lot of drama, and you don't wanna be around that because it takes away from production, takes away from your focus, takes away from the machine going to the next level. So we really looked at that. I looked at that, you know, personally and said, okay, who do I wanna do business with? You know, who's somebody that has the same mindset, who's looking out for us, we're looking out for them, and really grow together. So that's a big thing. At the end of the year, whatever business you're in, you have to look at those relationships and say, hey, was just, you know, were, you know, dealing with these people here or dealing with this one individual here, was that worth it? And so you really have to look at that. And sometimes you just have to move on and just keep on expanding. So that's number two. Number three, I wrote these down obviously here because I'm driving and I will forget a couple of these. We have a lot more options now than we did last year as far as financing. We just closed, Shannon Counts, my senior loan officer here in Tennessee, just closed 100% financing, conventional. Okay. So we have that. We have some other products here. You know, we do some double wides now. So we have a lot of different options that we didn't have before, that we are capturing a lot more of the business of the marketplace right now. So that's huge. Okay. So we have that going for us right now. And then number three, systems. You know, our systems, when you're in a system, this is something I learned too, because, you know, everybody who's been in a mortgage business or real estate business, everybody has moved around quite a bit. The biggest thing, and it took me, and it's so simple, so it tells you how smart I am. It's the biggest thing that I learned is being consistent. Just being consistent, okay? Instead of bouncing here, bouncing there, chasing the shiny tool, once you're in the system, it's never going to be perfect. Never, ever, ever going to be perfect, okay? But the system, if you have the system of consistency, okay, and you're in that system, and you keep on growing within in that system and still improve that system, okay, internally with our team and internally with Hancock, when you start improving that system more and more and more and getting better, it takes away a lot of the unknown factors. Okay, I know people at other companies, other brokers, and they have problems with getting docs out. They have problems with underwriting. They have problems with turn times. You don't really come across that stuff. And that's huge for building your business. You have to have that. You can't be worrying about that stuff. It's gotta be, okay, boom, this happens, boom, this happens, boom, this happens. It's gotta be a machine. Yeah, things happen. Sometimes you're gonna have to get in, you know, involved a little bit more. But that's so rare. It's so rare. You've gotta be so, you know, in the zone of growing your business and not worrying about that stuff. You know, people have to do their job, and you don't have to worry about them doing their job. And that's a key, okay? A lot of times, you know, people just have to worry about every little micromanaged thing, and they're never going to grow. They're actually going to go backwards. So that is the biggest thing too, is us being consistent. So 4 points here, I think it's really helped us this year. And like I said, we're up to about 19.6 million at the end of April in closings. Once again, our average loan size is 181. I mean, we don't have like a team of 10 loan officers running around, you know? We have basically three LOs, and then we have two LOs who are coming on board now, who've been working with us now, and they're starting to ramp up. But it's basically, it's not a team of like 10 people running around and each loan officer doing one loan a piece here. So a big thing, just to recap here, I think where we're going here, and once again, we've almost doubled. I mean, 19.6 compared to like 11.5 after April. So not quite double, but you know, our goal is to get over 60 million, and the summer hasn't even started. So it's good news. So people, you have to have the right people. Relationships, look at your business relationships. Who do you want to do business with? Number three is options, okay? We have a lot more options now than we did before. And then number four, just being consistent, having those systems in place and tight and everything else. So very, very happy where things are going. Man, a quiet time in the morning always helps reflect. And so grateful for everybody on our team, so grateful for everybody at Hancock. It's just good stuff that's happening. So if you need any help, if you got any questions, comment down below. Just shoot me a private message or text me at 423-262-9229. Shoot me a private message on Facebook or just comment down below. Have a great Monday. I'll talk to you soon.